Like to take a seat for a moment. Dear brothers and sisters, we are gathered here today to pray for the soul of Tommy Fallon, who died peacefully in his sleep on Thursday morning, November the 12th, at Our Lady of Lourdes Hospital, Drogheda. On behalf of Holy Family Parish, I and Father Stephen wish to express our condolences to the family members, especially to his wife, Bridie, his daughter, Gráinne, and sons, Kieran and Emmett, son-in-law, Seamus, daughter-in-law, Karen, grandchildren, even Ellen and Dara, sister, Carol, brothers Leo and Dermot, and extended family relatives during this time of sorrow. The funeral liturgy and Mass this morning enable the Christian community to mourn as well as experience hope by focusing on the saving mystery of Jesus' death and resurrection. Every individual has something to contribute to society, and Tommy was one such person. Tommy was born and raised in Bohir Brua, Drogheda, and subsequently moved to 18 Dunnoa Road, where he and his wife Bridie and subsequent three children established their family home. Tommy was a man with a strong personality, witty, and loved everything Irish. He trained as an aircraft electrician and was respected and known to be a hard-working man, gifted with the ability to put his hand to anything, from building all the wardrobes in their family home to gardening. Tommy had an interesting career, joining the HMSE British Navy at the young age of 16 years and gave them 9 full years of service. He turned his skills to working in the house building industry, and despite the difficult circumstances that followed from his accident, he continued to live a life as best he could. Tommy became ill about 14 years ago and maintained his battle to continue as best he could with the help and care of Bridie, his wife, and family. The Fallon family thanks sincerely the community nurses and carers, My Home Care, and their GP, Dr. Eric Yelverton, for their kindness and care of Tommy during his illness. Tommy has departed from this earth, but has left his family and relatives and friends with some happy memories and something to treasure for the rest of their lives. We pray today at this Mass for the repose of Tommy's soul, asking God to grant him eternal rest with him in his kingdom of heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Tommy, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. First reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom. For everything, there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, a time to lose. A time to keep, a time to cast away. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. God has made everything beautiful and beautiful in its time. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient, love is kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. In short, there are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Please stand. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Dear friends, we are united with you today in sorrow at the death of Tommy. The reality of death, with all its pain and sense of loss, confronts us at this moment. But as we are united in sorrow, we are also united by something else: our faith. Confronted with the reality of death, we must allow ourselves to be confronted with the reality of our faith. The reality, not a maybe, or I hope so, or fantasy, or wishful thinking, but a reality. Our faith opens our minds to the whole picture about life and death and what happens after death. Only in the light of our faith can we begin to understand what has happened to Tommy and how we are to keep going from here. When in our faith we speak about heaven and resurrection and the next life, we do not speak about these things primarily because they give us consolation and strength. They certainly do that. But the primary reason we speak of these things is because they are true. God has spoken his word to us. We hear it in the scriptures and in the teachings of our church. And we respond to it by saying, "Yes, I believe. It is true." God has broken the silence about death and told us that he has conquered it. Death was not part of God's original plan. It came into the world because of sin. Death is not from God. Death is from turning away from God. Yet God did not leave us in death's power. He sent Christ, who died and rose again and conquered death. God has spoken to the world through Christ. and told us that he wants to give us victory over death in and through Jesus Christ. Because of this, Christians are not silent in the face of death. Many people, on coming to a wake or a funeral, do not know what to say. Death seems to have the last word. But we who believe are not silent. We speak, Christ is risen. Death has been conquered. Many people think that the story of human life is birth, life, and death. For Christians, it's different. The story is not birth, life, and death, but rather life, death, and resurrection. Death does not have the last word. Life does. Death is not the last period after the last sentence of the last chapter of the human story. There's another chapter to come. Death is not the end of the human story. It's the middle. The end of the story is resurrection and a life that has no end. The farewell that we give to Tommy today is a temporary farewell. The burial we give Tommy is a temporary burial. He will live, he will rise again. And that's our Christian faith. Here, let us stand. Dear brothers and sisters, in confidence we approach the throne of God's grace, that we shall have mercy from him and find grace when we are in need of help. Lord, we pray that today you welcome Tommy into your heavenly home where he can rest from his labors. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for Tommy's family. May the Lord console them, guide them, and protect them. Lord, hear us. We pray for Tommy's relations, friends, and all here present who mourn his passing. May they be comforted in the knowledge that he is released from his suffering and gone to his eternal reward. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who cared for Tommy during his illness. May God reward them for their gentleness and love and keep them safe from all harm. Lord, hear us. Incline your merciful ear to our prayers, O Lord, and listen in kindness to the supplications of those who call on you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Yeah.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Tommy, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. And with your spirit, lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so would angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. If you can, please kneel. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most blessed spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Tom, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Tommy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Grant to our departed brothers and sisters, to at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to their kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, please stand. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. If you can, please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Because of the coronavirus restrictions imposed on the priests and on the country, the priests will go down to the pews and give Holy Communion to those who wish to receive Holy Communion. If I can just go down to the center here first, first people in the pew here, I give Holy Communion. And for the people on the right side here, from the middle down, if they want to move out, I'd come down to each pew and I walk my way down to the back, and I come around this side and I'll do this side and then to the people on each side. So if you bear with me as I give out Holy Communion.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Tommy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Tommy. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We pray now in silence for Tommy. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him. Angels of the Lord, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. And may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Tommy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of fate until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our brother forever. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother Tommy to his place of rest.